LeBron was fairly impressed by, who they were. also because, you know, he also wanted to have his company, his brand. But, you know, it was a good idea for him to help out his family and whatnot, because I know his kids go to school. Offseason, even though it's probably too late to even ask for it, but you know, just comment down below, maybe your opinions on it. Also, the team they built around LeBron is very different. you know, with Lance Davis and JaVale McGee and going to the Warriors, which is pretty dumb, pretty unfair. But I mean, if no other teams offered him a contract, I can't really complain. Other teams are just really dumb, I guess. So that's going to be really interesting to see this season. How will they do? How will they cope together? And, you know, if any of the other players, hint, Klay Thompson, option on the team, which would be crazy to think. So maybe, you know, he leaves or Draymond leaves and, you know, DeMarcus Cousins stays. That'd be crazy. But I guess we'll see. Another big thing that happened this offseason was Kawhi Leonard finally being freed from the San Antonio Spurs. Could have got probably something better in return, more of a young star, someone to build around. You know, everybody heard the talks about the Lakers, and you know, if I was the Lakers, I would probably give up Kawhi for Brandon Ingram and, you know, picks and Josh Hart and whatnot. But you know, knowing the Spurs, they're probably very stubborn about who they were trading to and what they were getting back. So, they probably wanted like Lonzo Ball and Brandon Ingram and, you know, maybe even Kuzma or something like that. But, you know, I guess we'll see how healthy Kawhi is. You know, if he's healthy, you know, the Raptors are going to be probably making it at least the conference finals against probably the Boston Celtics, in my opinion. But I'll get that all in the next video. It's going to be the East next year. That's all I'm going to say is like the East next year. Eastern Conference playoffs is going to be amazing. I'm definitely going to watch probably all the series. Or at least probably the second round, because, you know, it's so wide open. You're never really going to know who's really going to come out of there. It could be, you know, Toronto or Boston or the Sixers or, all falls to injury, and you never know who's going to get injured. So, I'm pretty interested to see. But yeah, I'm not doubting DeMar DeRozan at all. DeMar DeRozan is a really great player. I really liked reading that article about him, about expressing his anxiety and his depression that came out a little while ago when that Kevin Love one came out, and just hearing about, you know, his struggles with that. And I couldn't imagine having literally a whole city, you know, like Toronto, which, you know, Toronto is definitely a basketball city. I know they have the Blue Jays over there, but I mean, the city is just so surrounded by, you know, Vince Carter and Drake and all that stuff, you know, it's kind of hard to not call Toronto Basketball City. So having that all on your back probably puts a lot on you. So, I mean, shout out to DeMar DeRozan. I think he's going to do. He's definitely going to get his when he's there, but it's going to be weird to see the Spurs without, you know, Tim Duncan, Tony Parker, Manu Ginobili, now they're all gone. That's really sad, actually. I mean, like, my favorite, you know, decade of basketball is definitely the 2000s. That was definitely a fun time to watch. It's weird to think that all these players are retiring, but, you know, time definitely moves by very fast. Magazine at all. Glenn Rice won MVP of the All-Star game in 1997. I did not know that. He scored 20 points to break the All-Star game record for points in a quarter as the East went on a 44-7 run that led to its 132-120 victory. It's funny because how reversed the NBA was back then. You know, the East really dominated back in the 90s. Into the 2000s, you really saw like a battle between the East and the West. But now it's just so packed in the West. It's pretty crazy. I mean, I know definitely probably next 10 years it's going to be the East. East is going to dominate the West with people like Giannis, Joel, and Ben Simmons. I'm sleeping on some people in the East. Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown. I'm trying to think. Maybe Kevin Knox. He would look pretty good in the summer league. But those players in 10 years, if they stay loyal, which, I mean, I've heard Giannis said, you know, he wants to stay in Milwaukee his whole career. So, next 10 years is going to be dominated by the East, I think. When LeBron's retired and Kevin Durant, Steph Curry, all these players now that are here are gone, you know, it's definitely going to be dominated by the East. What was I saying? I don't remember what got me here. Sorry. How are you doing? Talk to you guys at all, really. So really, if you guys want to have a little conversation in the comment section, I'm more than willing to. You guys know, if you comment down in my comment section, I'm either liking it or replying to it. So, you know, tell me how you guys are doing. Maybe some new things that are in your life. What's going on with your teams? Are you excited about your teams? Expectations of your teams? Other sports you're like, are interested in? This is kind of cool. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me try and zoom in on this. Can you guys see that? Oh yeah, you guys can, kind of. Barely. Anyways, this kind of is the playoff bracket for last year's 1997 NBA playoffs. This was back when it was only a five game series. I think so. Best of there's a sweep there. I'm too young for this. If any of you are like old heads or some oldies who know about this, so if you sweep in three games, if you win three games in a row, you automatically go to the next round, I guess. But it's a 7-game series. That's weird. Portland lost to the Lakers 1997. Who was on the Blazers then? Drexler then. Wow. Anyways, Lakers lost then. I wonder if the Lakers had on their team during those times. It was Magic. I think Magic was still in the league then, 97. Yeah, I think so. Rice and Alonzo Mourning. These game scores are crazy, though. This one was 84-82 to the Bulls. Only scoring 80 points this game four. Over here, you can't even really see. But these game scores are super low. Let's see if I can zoom in on them a little more. This one scores 78-73 to the Jazz. Could you imagine nowadays if a team only scored 70 points a game, they'd get slaughtered in the media. I'm trying not to keep this video too long. The Heat won 61 games this year. This year, I keep saying this year and last year. In 1997, the Heat won 61 games. The Knicks won 57. The Bulls won 69 games. Raptors won 30. Boston Celtics won 15. Wow, that's crazy. I think they only had two divisions. They had Atlantic and Central. And then for the West, they had Midwest and Pacific. That's crazy. Utah won 64 games. Houston won 57. The Grizzlies won 14. The Warriors won 30. Blazers won 49 games. It's not bad, not bad. Carmelo was the MVP. Sorry, that was loud. Carmelo won the MVP. You can't really see that, but I'm trying. Coach of the Year was Pat Riley. Makes sense. Rookie of the Year was Allen Iverson. Whoa. Allen Iverson. They won 22 games that year. Most Improved Player was Isaac Austin of Miami. Defensive Player of the Year was Dikembe Mutombo. And Sixth Man of the Year was John Starks. If any of you people are Knicks fans, you can tell me who started over John Starks. I thought he was always a starter on the Knicks, but I guess not. An all-star. Eddie Jones was an all-star. Some of these players I don't even know. Steve Kerr was a three-point shootout champion. Dennis Rodman was the best rebounder. Michael Jordan, best scorer, obviously. Glenn Rice, man. Glenn Rice got... Oh wait, Glenn Rice was on the Hornets. My bad. I was wrong. Tim Hardaway, Paz was on the Heat. Tim Hardaway, duh. Steve Smith. Chris Webber, when he was on the Bullets, he's on the list of scorers. Mark Jackson led the league in assists. That's dope. A lot of players on here I don't really know the name of. I think this was actually Shaq's first year on the Lakers. Because there's Shaquille O'Neal on the Lakers. When did they get out of the playoffs? Or they lost to Utah this year. I didn't know that. I'm really sorry if you hear that. Let's go back into this coming season. I'm trying to think of other big things that really happened this offseason. Carmelo. crazy to think that this is Dwayne Wade's last season. Like, let's just all take a second. This is Dwayne Wade's last season. I can't even comprehend. Dwayne Wade, definitely the third best shooting guard of all time. You can argue about that in the comments if you want. This Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, Dwayne Wade, like, that's me, that's for me, you know, one of the best shooting guards we've ever seen, you know, he was so, when Dwayne Wade was in his prime, I mean, Kobe was the only better player than him, probably, maybe Shaq, he was definitely top five, top three in the NBA in his prime. Especially if you guys, if any of you are younger or just haven't seen that Miami-Dallas series back in 2006, watch those games and watch Dwayne Wade. Like, that wasn't even, like people back then probably would have said that was, you know, Dwayne Wade was too young back then, but he was playing like a star. He stole the show, definitely. On a team with Shaq and going against Dirk Nowitzki, like, he definitely was the best player out there. So yeah, it's great to think it's his last year. I mean, if Carmelo has another really bad year, it might even be Carmelo's last year. You might not even know. It's kind of scary to think about. Sounds kind of cliche or just bad, but it's kind of hard, you know, making these videos and then having, you know, work and other stuff. You know, it's not like my livelihood, you know what I mean? So, I'm definitely doing this for fun, and, you know, I love ASMR. If you know me or been around a while, you know, like, ASMR has been a part of my life for probably like 6 years, 7 years. You know, back when, like, Ephemeral Rift was like a nobody. No shots at Ephemeral Rift, though, but, you know, back when people back then didn't know what ASMR even was, and, you know, so, I definitely love making these videos, and I love talking to you guys in the comments, so make sure you guys leave a comment. I'm still trying to think about other things that happened this offseason. I know all the rookies I could have talked about, but I'm gonna save that for next video. Talking about the rookies and, like, rookie of the year and how I think the rookies are going to impact their teams. And teams that I have high hopes for, teams I think that are overlooked, teams I think.